Good afternoon, students. Welcome for the video class for data science. So, in this third unit, basic political concept, we already completed four basic concepts in that sovereignty, law, liberty, equality. These four basic concepts we completed. Now, today we'll start with the fifth and the last basic concept, that is rights. So before starting concept, would like to tell you one short incident or one situation, what you will do in that situation. So one situation ki tarah hai, lekin yahan par nim aapke kare bane nim ancestor dalla nim shakti aa bodu mani aa ಒಬ್ಬ ಕೆಲವೊಂದು ಜನ ಇಲ್ಲಾಂದ್ರೆ ಒಬ್ಬ ಜನ ಏನು ಮಾಡ್ತ ಅದ್ರ ಮೇಲೆ ಸ್ವಂತ ರೈಟ್ ಇಂದ ಆ ಜಮೀನ್ ಅವನು ಬೇಕು ಹೇಳ್ತ ಎಸೆ ಸಿಚುವೇಶನ್ ಕ್ಯಾಂಗೆ ಜಬ್ ಆಕೆ ದಾದ ದಾದಿ ಜಮೀನ್ ಪರ ಕೋಯಿ ದೂಸರಾ ವ್ಯಕ್ತಿ ಆಕರ್ ಕಬ್ಜಾ ಕರ್ತಾ ಕ್ಯಾ ಕರೋಗೇ ಪಹಲೆ ಪೊಲೀಸ್ ಸ್ಟೇಷನ್ ಮೇಲೆ ಜಾಕರ್ ಕಂಪ್ಲೇಂಟ್ ಕರೋಗೇ ಕಿ ಇಸ್ ವ್ಯಕ್ತಿ ಮೇರೆ ಜಮೀನ್ ಪರ ಕಬ್ಜಾ ಕಿಯಾ ಹೈ. दूसरा, आप कोर्ट में जाओगे और वहां पे केस रजिस्टर करोगे पुलिस स्टेशन से एफआईआर लेके. ओके, तो कोर्ट में आपको क्या क्या करना पड़ेगा? एक तो आपको उस जमीन के कागज दिखाने पड़ेंगे, उस जमीन पर आपका अधिकार है, आपका आपका ही हक है और आप ही उसके वारिसदार हो, तो ये आपको प्रूव करना पड़ेगा. सो यू शुड हैव अ डॉक्यूमेंट विच मेक्स यू owner of that area, owner of that land. So here, that is your right. So as you show that, as you get the proof, if it is proved, it's your land, definitely that land will belong to you. Dusra koi aapke zameen par kabza nahi kar sakta, jabki wo zameen aapki hai, aapke naam par hai, aapka wo adhikar hai. So it's your right to have that land. So because of only right, you will get your land back if someone takes them off. So rights are very important to protect your land, property, your rights, and your all the things. Your liberty, life, and property all are going to be protected. So what is exactly right? So, rights are the conditions or opportunities essential for the development of personality of individual. What it is? Conditions, rights are the conditions or opportunities. Rights are the conditions or the opportunities for the development of essential for the development of personality. So here it is important condition or opportunity, development of personality of individual. For my development of my personality, what opportunity or condition I am getting, it is called as rights. Okay, even these rights are going to protect your life, property and right, property and liberty also. Rights protect person's life, liberty and property. That's why I told that example of that situation where the person's life is protected, liberty is protected, and property also is protected. अगर आपके पास हक है तो उसी हक के कारण आप पुलिस स्टेशन जा सकते हो या फिर कोर्ट में जा सकते हो और अपना केस लड़ सकते हो, और उस केस में आप जीत गए तो वो आपकी प्रॉपर्टी रहेगी, आपको लिबर्टी मिल जाएगी. सो दीज पॉइंट्स आर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर द प्रोटेक्टिंग लाइफ लिबर्टी ऑफ वंस इफ समवन इज गेट किडनैप्ड. ओके, और ही इज गिविंग यू वार्निंग लाइक दैट लाइक अ ड्रीम. So you can case the file in the court against that person who is warning you or who others gives you for that I will cut off you. Yaro tum band padte ho, khade the ho, ee tar maat nahi karte ho, warning bolta ho, dhamki bolta ho, aap vyakti ko bhi ya aap vyakti bandhu pain maro case maro, because you have the right to liberty, right to freedom. No one makes you as a custodian. If someone kidnaps you, someone calls you for the murder, so you can go for the court, you can go for the police station. Okay? So, the rights protect life, liberty and property of the person. So here, these rights are very important. So for that right, H.J. Luskin, what is covered? State is known by the rights that it maintains. What kind of rights the state is going to be maintained by that it will come to know. जैसे हम अपने वस्तु रहते हैं, अपने कुछ प्रिंसिपल्स रहते हैं. समटाइम आई विल बी वेरी पोलाइट, समटाइम आई विल बी एवरी टाइम आई विल बी पोलाइट, ट्रूथफुल, सिंसियर. सो बाय दीज क्वालिटी यू विल बी आइडेंटिफाइड बाय पीपल. एज आई से स्टेट विल बी नोन बाय इट्स राइट व्हाट यू मेंटेन. सो द राइट्स आर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. And these rights are going to be protected everywhere, which gives you development of personality. And these all the rights are going to be socially accepted. Makes man life happy, harmonious and worth living. Rights means man's life happy, harmonious, happy, harmonious and worth living. Happy will live together, to celebrate all things. Harmonious, unity. After having differences in between number of people, then also we live together. ಯಾವುದು ಸೆಲೆಬ್ರೇಷನ್ ಇರಲಿ, ಓಕೆ, ಫೇರ್ ಫೆಸ್ಟಿವಲ್ ಸೆಲೆಬ್ರೇಷನ್ ಇರಲಿ, ನಾವೆಲ್ಲ ಏನು ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ, ಕೂಡೆ ಸೆಲೆಬ್ರೇಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ, ಎಲ್ಲ ಒಂದು ಜೊತೆ ಬಂದ ಸೆಲೆಬ್ರೇಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ ವಿತ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪಿ. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ವರ್ಕ್ ಲಿವಿಂಗ್ ಸಮ್ ಟೈಮ್ ಕೆಲವು ಟೈಮ್ ನಾವು ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ, ನಾವೇ ಜೀವನ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ, ಇಲ್ಲಾದ್ರೆ ಅನ್ಸ್ ಲೈಫ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್. There will not be any kind of status, there will not be any kind of happiness. But we live, what the human beings will live, that living should be worth living when you are making the rights. Okay? So, the rights means person's life happy, harmonious and worth living only because of rights. Okay, so this is in short. Now, we'll see different definitions given by the political thinkers. Okay? So we can see here. Definitions. So first definition is given by the T.H. Green. what he has told about the rights and how he has defined. Rights are power necessary to fulfillment of man's vocation as a moral being. Rights are power necessary to the fulfillment vocation that is worth what we have accepted, vocation of a moral being. So D.H. Green, right, has defined rights are power to fulfill the necessary or fulfill the man's vocation of the moral being as a being moral. A moral being, what we have values, so that is our worth. So to complete that work, what power we have, that is rights. Understand, students? What my work is there, value work is there, to complete that value work, to complete that vocation. Vocation is nothing but the task or work it is. So complete that work, what power is needed, that power is a right. It has been defined by T.H. Green. Okay, next one we'll see. Second definition of right is a person's claim. So what he has defined, a right is claim recognized by the society and enforced by the state. A right is a claim recognized by society. Now whatever we want, that is our right. So we have recognized it. We identified it. Society has identified it, and it is enforced by the state. As per the societies, whatever the things are made and enforced by the state, that is rights. Okay, it has been told by the Bosanquet. Next is H. J. Lusky. He too has defined about the rights. The right, in fact, those conditions of social life without which no man seek in general to be himself is best. It is a condition of social life without which no man seek in general to be himself and is best. Without this condition, man cannot be himself best in the society. So this condition itself is known as a right. Without that social conditions, without the rights, man can't be best in his life. So these are the different definitions of the rights. Okay? Now, we can see that these rights, in general, we can classify these rights only into the two parts. So basically, we can divide them into two parts. So classification we will see now. So in general, we can classify rights into the two categories. One is moral rights.
And second interest is legal rights.
So what is moral right and what are the legal rights? So the moral rights, which are going to be based on the different kinds of customs, traditions, public opinion and uses.
Moral rights based on the customs, traditions, public opinion and uses.
So whatever customs, traditions are there and public opinion, whatever the demands are there from the public, so on the base of these moral rights are defined. So what do you find here? Do you find if the person does not follow the moral rights, can you give any kind of punishment to him? Legal punishment you can't give in this moral rights. Yahu tara legal yamke mata kaadam illa, legal punishment kuda kaadam illa. So moral ka no legal punishment.
Moral right.
No legal punishment here, but people will operate by the society. So what we can do? What we can do as a punishment in society? We can boycott the person from the society. So the people always will be in a fear of social boycott. Fear of social boycott. Boycott अंदर समाजवादी नाम में मारना और करना है। इसके कारण समस्या यही रहता है कि कारण समाज वापस लग सकता है। अंदर वो रेटिंग युवाओं को रंगरे नहीं मिलता हो। अंदर फॉलो मारते हो। अंदर यार आदमी चेंज मारे हो। ಅವ್ರಿಗೆ ಏನು ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ ಸಮಾಜದಲ್ಲಿ ಹೊರಗಡೆ ಹಾಕೋದು ಅವ್ರಿಗೆ ಯಾವುದೇ ರೀತಿ ಸಹವಾಸ ಮಾಡೋಕ್ಕಿಲ್ಲ ಯಾವುದೇ ರೀತಿ ಮತ್ತು ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಮಾಡೋದಿಲ್ಲ ಮಾತುಕತೆಯನ್ನು ಬಿಡ್ತಾರೆ ಸಮಾಜದಲ್ಲಿ ಯಾವುದೇ ಒಂದು ಫಂಕ್ಷನ್ ಕರೆಯೋಂಗಿಲ್ಲ ಯಾರು ಅವ್ರ ಮನೆಗೆ ಹೋಗೋದಿಲ್ಲ ಅವರು ಯಾರ ಮನೆಗೆ ಹೋಗೋದಿಲ್ಲ ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಫಿಯರ್ ಆಫ್ ಸೋಷಿಯಲ್ ಬೈಕಾಟ್ ಬಹಿಷ್ಕಾರ ಹಾಕ್ಬಿಡ್ಬೋದು ನಮ್ಮ ಫ್ಯಾಮಿಲೀಸ್ ಕೆಲವೊಂದು ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಹಾಕೋದ್ರೆ ಯಾವುದೇ ಒಂದು ಸಮಾಜ ಹುಡುಗಿ ಗಂಡು ಹುಡುಗಿ ಬೇರೆ ಹುಡುಗಿಯ ಕೂಡ ಜೊತೆ ಮದುವೆ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ ಅಂತ ವಿಷಯದಾಗ ಆ ಸಮಾಜ ಆ ಒಂದು ಫ್ಯಾಮಿಲಿಗೆ ಏನು ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ ಸಮಾಜ ಅವನ ಹಾಕ್ಬಿಡ್ತಾರೆ ಬರಬೇಡ ಹಾಕ್ಬಿಡ್ತಾರೆ ಯಾಕಂದ್ರೆ ಅವ್ರ ಪ್ರೀತಿ ವಿವಾಹ ಪರಂಪರೆ ಏನು ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ಫಾಲೋ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಮೇನ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಆಲ್ವೇಸ್ ದ ಮಾರಲ್ ಲಾ ಮಾರಲ್ ರೈಟ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಬೇಸ್ಡ್ ಆನ್ ದಿ ಫಿಯರ್ ಆಫ್ ಸೋಷಿಯಲ್ ಬೈಕಾಟ್ Here, violation of these moral rights not invites any kind of punishment. Legal punishment will not be there, but people will afraid about the fear of the society's boycott. That is very important one. So the people, when they live in society, they will think about the traditions, rights, moral values about that things, because it's very difficult in the Indian society go against with the traditions. Hamare samaj mein ya chahe jo bhi samaj ho, dharm ho ya phir koi bhi ek religion ya jati ho, har ek jati ke har ek dharm ke apne apne riti rivaj paramparaye hoti hai. Un paramparaon ke anusar hum apna jeevan jeete hain, अपने फेस्टिवल्स, सेलिब्रेशन सब कुछ सेलिब्रेट करते हैं, लेकिन कोई इसके खिलाफ जाता है तो उस व्यक्ति को अपने समाज से निकाल दिया जाता है.
The people don't like any one of a person, any one of a family who interfere in the customs and traditions. That person, that family will be boycotted. Okay. And next उदाहरण आपको मिल जाएंगे. Marriage के हुआ या फिर कोई भी celebration या फिर कोई भी रीति रिवाज अगर उनके खिलाफ जाता है, जैसे ज्योतिबा फुले जी ने किया था, वो तो एक अच्छे कुल के थे, उच्च जाति के थे, लेकिन उन्होंने क्या किया, निचली जाति के लोगों को जब शिक्षण देना शुरू किया, when he started giving education to the backward classes, SC, ST and even women, so the higher class or higher society people started throwing cow dung, dung के उनके ऊपर गोबर उछाला गया, उनको पत्थर से मारा गया, बिकॉज वो अपने रीति रिवाजों के खिलाफ जा रहे थे. लेकिन ऐसा जानना भी अच्छा रहता है, बिकॉज दैट पर्सन स्टार्टेड गिविंग एजुकेशन टू द वुमेन्स एंड गर्ल्स. सो द पीपल बिलोंग टू द हाई क्लास, दे हैव बॉयकॉटेड हिम एंड हिज फैमिली फ्रॉम द सोसाइटी. Number of example you will get, but when person is working good, then he don't need to bother about it if he is doing good. Even you might heard about it, Sant Nageshwari, who has written the Nageshwari in the 16th year, and the family higher class also boycotted his family also, because his father, he got once a celebration. As a being sage, he got married later. So for that purpose, he was boycotted. So all the moral rights are based on customs, traditions, and public opinion and views. If person goes against it, there will be a punishment by the society, not legal punishment. Government can't give any kind of punishment for that. If they go against the traditions, customs, just they will affect about the society and its punishment or boycott. When moral rights are recognized by the state, they become the legal rights. About the legal rights, when this is all the rights, it is recognized by the state, then those all the rights become the legal rights, and if someone goes against with the legal right, person will get the punishment legally. There will be a legal punishment, a person who goes against the legal rights. So you can see that the legal rights are recognized and maintained by the law. Legal rights are recognized and maintained by the law, and these rights are guaranteed and enforced by the law as well as state. So there is a guarantee and enforcement of the law by the government. So those person, if violated the legal law, definitely there will be a punishment. For example, ट्रैफिक में आप फंसे हुए हैं, आपको जल्दी जाना है, तो आपने ट्रैफिक का रूल तोड़ दिया, रेड लाइट लगने पर भी आपने रास्ता क्रॉस किया बाइक से या फिर आपकी कोई भी कार हो, तो आपको वो जो रोड ऑफिसर रहता है, ट्रांसपोर्ट ऑफिसर रहता है, तो वो आपको पकड़ेगा और आपका चलन फाड़ेगा, 300 रुपये, 500 रुपये या फिर 1000 रुपये का भी हो सकता है. बिकॉज इट वॉज लीगल राइट, शुड नॉट क्रॉस एनी रोड व्हेन देयर इज अ traffic signal, red traffic signal. Okay, so these are the two, a classification of rights, moral right and legal rights. So these legal rights, which are going to be divided into three kinds: civil right, political right and economic right. So those three rights we'll see in the next video, because those again have the parts, those we will see in a deep in the next video. So this is a brief information about the rights. Meaning and definition, we see rights are the conditions or the opportunities for for the development of the person's development of personality of individual, and these rights protect the person's life, property as well as liberty also. Then we see definitions, okay, different definitions given by the political thinkers, and two broadly two classifications of the rights. One is moral right, second one is legal right. Moral rights, which are based on the customs, traditions, public opinion and usages. But in the moral rights, no legal punishment, but there will be fear of the social boycott. And legal rights, which are protected, guaranteed and enforced by the law. There will be a legal punishment for the legal right. These all are recognized by the state. Okay? So in detail we will see about the legal rights in the next video. Thank you for being up to the end of the video.